Hello there. This video is to talk about the commands grep and find. So find is actually used to find files, and grep is used to find patterns inside files. So I'm just going to show you examples, very basic examples of what you can do with it. So let's create a test directory inside the terminal. Test. Switch. There you go. We're inside the test directory. Inside the test directory, there is no files, which is going to be make it difficult to show you the commands. So first, I'm going to create 100 files with the touch command. They will be numbered from 1 to 100, named 1 to 100. There you go. You can see all of them. Now, let's say I'm looking for file number 10. It's gonna show it a result. File number 1000. It's gonna show you that it doesn't find it. Very easy. Let's say now that I want something more specific, or all the files that contain one in their name or start with one. So one star. This is the way you will do it. And here you have all the files that start with one. Let's say I want all the files that end with one. This is the way you will do it. All the files that end with one. And now let's say I want all the files that contain a one. So you do it this way. As you can see, it's actually a combination of the two previous command. And that's it for find, actually. Now, we have 100 files. Let's say I add file 101 and I put hello inside of it, the string hello. 101, there you go. So if I do cat of 101, hello is contained. And that's it for now. Let's assume I do not know what that hello string is, what that pattern is. I have 101 files and I have no idea where it is. So if I do a cat of one, I don't find anything, it's empty. Cat of two, anything, it's empty. And I do not want to go through all the files. And I just want to find where is that pattern. So in this case, you use the grep command. Grep command, and you look for the pattern, hello. And you have to specify where you look for it. So I'm not gonna put one and one by one, right? I'm gonna put all the files that are here with the star. And here's the result. It went through all the files in the current directory and found 101. So this is it for now, for this very basic presentation of those two commands. You will need to dig a bit deeper into them, depending on the exercises. And you need to do some online research, read the man a bit. That's it for now. This is the very basic use of them. Thank you for your attention, and I'll see you in the next video.